Okay, good evening everyone. So we are going to start with our next topic. So today we are going to be discussing about Google Docs. So before we move into Google Docs, last time we had done Chrome and Drive. Anybody has any doubt in Drive or Chrome?
No, ma'am.
Okay, so we can start with Google Doc. I'll just share my screen. So there are three ways by which I can access Google Doc. The first one is I go on my Gmail account. I hope this screen is visible to everyone.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. I go on my Gmail. I go to the waffle, that is the nine dots. I click on it and I go to the option Doc. So a new doc will open. This is the first way. Second one is I go to the waffle again. I go to Drive. When the Drive folder opens, I go on New and I go to Google Doc. So this is second way. I select a blank document. And the third option is I click on a new tab. I type Google doc.google.com and the whole page will open. So these are the three ways by which we can access Google Doc. It depends on us, whichever way is convenient to us, we can use that. I'll just close the extra ones. We'll use only one. So when I have the Google Docs open, if you can see, this is the template gallery. So template gallery, if I just see what are the options available. So there I have the templates which are already available for writing an essay, for writing reports, for writing class notes, for making a lesson plan, for writing letters, both formal, informal, business letters, for writing resume, or for making recipes. So I have different formats available. So if I want to do something related to that particular format, suppose I want to make a brochure or I want to make a newsletter, I can just click on this, the whole format will come and I'll just have to edit it according to what I want to make. But today we are not going to use any template. We are going to use a blank document. So I'll open a blank document. The first and the most important thing after you open any Google Doc is to name it. So let's name it as Day 2 File. Now you can see different options here. There's File, there's Edit, there's View, Insert, Format, Tools, Add-ons, and Help. Help is something that you're supposed to use when you're not getting any information or when you're not able to access something. Just type in search, you will get the help already available over there. Now for this session, we are going to start with Insert, then we will go to Format, Tools, and then we will come to File. So if I click on Insert, there are different options which come. So I can insert an image on the Google Doc, I can insert a table, I can insert a drawing, chart, horizontal line, date, which is a new feature, header and footer, page number, link. So we'll be doing all this one at a time. So if I go to insert image, the first option is upload from computer. So I just click on this. I'll see what all is available on desktop for me. So if I have these issues which are available, okay, so I'll select it. So this is how I've uploaded it. This is very simple, like we did it for Drive. You save it on the desktop and from there you upload it on the computer. Like I told you last time, on a Google Doc or a sheet or a slides, all of the information gets saved automatically. So if you can see here, last edit was seconds ago because I just edited the document. So when you're adding this, when you're sharing this sheet with other teachers, when you're adding collaborators, it gives you the information as to who has edited the document recently. Next option in insert is you go to image, you search the web. So when I click on search the web, a new tab opens here on the right hand side. So for example, I want to search for largest flower. Largest flower in the world. Okay, so I'm getting these images. So I can select any one of that. I drag it here and it comes on the screen, on the dock. I'll just show it again. So for example, if I want to take this blue color flower, or if I want to take this flower, I'll just drag it. Okay, when I drag it, it is showing me creating images, and this flower image has come here. So this is one of the way from web. Or if you can see this star icon on the lower side, are you able to see this explore? Teachers?
Yes, ma'am, we can see.
Yeah. So you can click on explore. Okay. So when you click on explore, you again get search your docs and around the and the web. So if I put here, let's take Neeraj Chopra, he's very famous nowadays. So I'll put Neeraj Chopra. Okay. So when I click on this option, explore, I get three alternatives there. So I can either search from the web, I can use an image, or I can take it from my drive if I have anything related to Neeraj Chopra in my drive. So if I'm taking it from web, okay? So for example, this is Wikipedia. What I'll do is I'll drag it here. So if you see, the whole link has come here. So if I click on this, it will take me to the page where all the information is given. For example, I want to take the Twitter post. I'll just drag it. Enter. I'm going to drag this. So when I'm dragging it, I'm going to get this. So when is this particular feature beneficial? For example, if you're working on something where you need to save a lot of links, so you can always use the explore option. And all the links that you're coming across, you can just drag it on the dock and all of it will get saved. So later on, you can use that for your reference. How do I add image? Image is same way like we had used from the insert tool by searching the web. So if I want to add an image, I'll click on this. I'll drag it and the image will come. The other option is I click on plus sign here and the image will come. So just dragging helps you to add the image to that particular doc on which you are working. Next is table option. Now, if you see here, I can select how many columns, how many rows I want. So when I'm going to make a table, I can use a table to match the following, or to give a comparison table to the students, or to summarize the whole chapter in short. So if I'm making a table with the four columns and four rows, okay? So this is the table which has been inserted. Now I can modify this table. Now with this table, if you see, there are few options which have been added here. So I can select the border color. If I want, I can make it red for one particular cell. If I want the whole table to be red, I'll select whole of it, I'll make it red. So the whole table border has become red. Now, if I want to increase the thickness, I'll go to this option, which is border width. I make it 2.25. If I don't want this border width to be shown, I make it 0. Table hai, but border nahi dikh raha hai. So after you have finished working and now you don't want the whole borders to be seen, you can use this option. So besides the pencil, there is border width option. If you go to 0.5, you are able to see the line. 0.75, the thickness will be increased. One, the thickness will increase further. You go to 2.5, it will be very thick. Now I have one more option in table borders. I'll select all of it. I'll go to the third option, which is border dash. When I click this, I'll get either normal line, I can get dotted lines, or the third option can be dotted lines with enough amount of gap in them. So depending on my requirement and depending upon why I'm making that table, I can select any one of it. Now, if this is the heading of my table, for example, this is P, this is Q, and this is R. I'll use this, I'll bring it to center. I'll make it bold because this is my heading. Now this whole heading, I want to color it. So I'll go to this color option, jar option. I'll make it yellow. If I want every alternate cell to be colored, then I'll click on this. I'll go to the jar, I'll select the color. So in this way, I can make the table more attractive for students so that they understand clearly what exactly we are studying. Is everyone clear till here? Any doubts? Teachers, if you have any doubts.
No, ma'am.
Okay. So the next option in insert is drawing. Now, when you select drawing, you go to new or from drive. So if you have any image which is already there in your drive, you can select it from there and you can add it. So for example, if I have this mind map, okay, so I'll select it. Link to source or unlink it. If you want to link it, you can link it. If you don't want it to be linked, then you can insert it, unlink. So I'm adding it. So this is the mind map which has come. If I'm making my own one, so I go to drawing, I go to new. This is the new tab which will open. So for example, this is undo button, this is redo button, this is magnify, this is an select, this is line, this is shape, text and image. So if I want to select a particular shape, for example, I want to take a square. So I'll take a square, I'll add another one. Let's take, I'm adding a circle, so I'll add a circle. If I want to add text, so I can write over here, identify the shapes if they're lower class students. So I'm identifying the shapes. Okay. If I want to add any image, so I can go to image where I can upload it from my computer by URL. So if I have to paste a URL, for example, if I want to put the image of a flower here, okay, I'll go to search, I'll go to image, I'll click on flower, I'll right click here, I'll open the image in a new tab, I'll copy this link and I'm going to add it here. You see this picture has come, I'll just select so that image will come here. So when you're using drawing as an option, you can add shapes, you can add text. When you're adding text, you can change the color of the background, you can change the color of the text, you can make it 3x or 4x, you can change the borders of the dash, you can change the font. If you want, you can select anyone, you can change the font size, and you can either bring it to center or move it to one of the sides. You can, if it's big paragraph, you can bring it to the middle. And these are all the options that are available. So if you want to make an image of your own, if you want to make a Google Doc where you're creating your own worksheet, so you can use this drawing option and you can create your own worksheet. So when I say save and close, all that I have done will get saved on this page. So instead of working on a page and then trying to locate all of it, I'll work there. So this whole has come as one image. So I can arrange the way in which I want it and then I can add it. Now I can edit it also. Now I saw that this was coming in one edge, so I brought it to the center. Now I do save and close. So now you see, identify the shapes in set is in center. There is an image here, there is a square rectangle here, there is a circle here. So this tool, drawing tool, is very important when you're making your own notes, when you're taking a small test with students. So for example, agar ek topic sikhaya hai and now you want to test whether they have understood it or not. So you can quickly prepare your own test and share this Google Doc with them. They can start working on it. Or you can share this on your screen and they can write the answers in their notebook. The next option is chart. So there are different types of chart options available. So if you want to insert a chart, you can use a bar chart. So it is inserting the chart. So this is a bar chart. You can modify the data which you have. You can link it with the data that you have. ठीक है. So charts generally हम लोग sheets में use करते हैं. So it becomes easier there to modify and to edit it. Horizontal line. Now for example, I am done with all that I am teaching, or I am done with the minutes of meeting for that particular day. So I can just go to insert. I'll go to horizontal line. There is a horizontal line which comes here. ठीक है. So this marks the end of that particular day. Now next day I want to start again. So what do I do? I go to insert. I go to date. This is a new feature which has come. Today is 25th August. So I'll select 25th. So you see the date has come here. So now whatever I do on 25th August, all of it will be recorded below this. So this feature is very important when you have a meeting and you're noting down the minutes of meeting. So generally हम लोग क्या करते हैं, बुक में लिखते हैं. Then sometimes you might happen to forget that book at home. So when you have the minutes of meeting of any department or of the school on a Google Doc, you can keep it date wise. Also, if the thing is shared with everyone, everyone knows what was discussed in that particular meeting, and they will be able to remember it and work on things accordingly. So I'll just show you all one example that we had done in school. So we had one of the event and we had to send a list of requirements to the students. So if you see, I first made a column. I added two small ones where I added images. I used a font. I changed the background color. So this is how you can work on it. So especially when you're working with grade 2, grade 3, grade 4 students, they tend to look at things which are more attractive. So now this whole page is white in color. I don't think so any child would like to read something that is white in color. So how do you change the color of the page? So you go to file, you go to page setup, you go to color, and for example, I want to take light blue color. So I'll take light blue color. Similarly, if I want portrait or landscape orientation, I can use that. Whether I want to apply it to whole document or selected part, that also I can select. So I'll do okay. So if you see, my page color has changed. So this is the one of the way by which you can change the page color and make it more attractive. Next option is adding a header and footer. So now to add a header and footer, first of all, what is a header and footer? Are you all aware of what exactly is a header and footer?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Can somebody quickly tell me?
Like header and footer, we basically use when for the whole document we want to put a particular, heading, or a footer is basically for the page number or something like that, ma'am. So that, if we want to put a logo of our school for all the documents, so we can put it in that header form. So we don't have to insert it again and again, na?
Yes, correct. So how do you add a header and footer on a Google Doc? So I'll just quickly take a new sheet.
Sure, ma'am.
So that I can show it to you. So, docs. I'll name it header and footer. So we were on the insert option. So I go to insert. I go here, header and footer. I click header. Okay, so I'll get this bar here, which is going to tell me ki iske upar wale part mein I can't edit anything. I can only write things which I want on all the pages. For example, you can keep your school logo here. You can keep the name of the chapter that you want to be repeated on each page. If there are some instructions which have to be repeated on all the pages, you can write it here. Right now, we'll just give it heading as header only. So I've written header. I go to font. I have changed the font. I have increased the font. I bring it to center. Okay. And now I'm going to add pages. Now let's see if the same heading comes on page 2. So if you see, page 2 pe same hai. If I go to footer, ठीक है, फुटर. नाउ ऑन फुटर आई वॉन्ट पेज नंबर्स टू कम, सो आई विल गो टू इंसर्ट, आई विल गो टू पेज नंबर. आई कैन इंसर्ट पेज नंबर ऑन टॉप राइट कॉर्नर, ऑन लोअर साइड, और वेर एवर यू वॉन्ट. सो आई हैव सिलेक्टेड दिस लेफ्ट कॉर्नर, सो दिस इज पेज वन, दिस इज पेज टू. So header and footer we are supposed to use when we want the same things to be repeated on each page. So you can't actually go and format each page. So agar maine yahan pe change kar diya, if I write header and I write for example physics likha hai maine, okay, so then same will be seen here. Any change done in header will be reflected on all the pages that are there in your document.
Okay.
Next option is adding special characters. Now special characters is to be used for arrows. Now for example, if I am taking this upward arrow, you see it's coming here. If I am taking two arrows, then it will come here. If I am taking arrow downward, I can use that. Okay. If I am going to emojis, then I have different emojis available here. So there is a smiley emoji, there is a sad emoji, there is one which is teasing. In fact, if you click at each of the emojis, it is telling you what it is. Now you must be wondering, hum log emojis ka kya karenge? So if you want to make a fun activity with small children, what you can tell them is use these emojis and make a story. So they can make a two-line story, a short story by using these emojis. So I was very happy. So after writing happy, side mein happy ka smiley dalo. So that way they'll also feel interested and they'll be excited to do that. You can add punctuation marks. So if you're not getting those punctuation marks on your keyboard, then you can use it from here. So these are the punctuation marks. And then you can add numbers. So these are the numbers that you can add, and there are other options which we generally don't use. So those are stroke radicals and stroke and Asian script and all those things. So those are not required by us. So this is one of the way by which you can insert the special characters when you have to insert an equation. Okay, so equations generally are associated with maths. So you go to insert, you click on equation. If you see, there is a box here. Now there are equations coming here, so I can click on this alpha, then I can select beta, then I can select delta. If I go to this option, I can select multiply, I can select divide, I can select star. So whatever match symbols I need, greater than equal to, less than equal to sign, all those signs that are required. Square root hoga, a upon b hoga, x raised to b hoga. So whatever symbols you require, generally it is difficult to write on a doc. So if I am going to insert, I go to equation, and I have selected a by b. Okay, so then there are blanks. I can write 5, and on the lower side I can write 7. So these are the different ways by which we can use the equations. So jo maths teachers hai, for them it is easy, the work gets simplified. Also page numbers we saw link. Now for example, if I have written a paragraph on Neeraj Chopra, okay, and I want my co-teachers to read the article behind it. So what I'll do is, if I'm taking, suppose I have taken Wikipedia or the, yeah, I've taken Wikipedia post and I have written something over there. So what I'll do is, I'll copy this link. I'll come to Neeraj Chopra, the word where I've written, because I want to hyperlink that. I'll right click, I'll click on link, I'll paste the link here, and I'll apply it. So when I click on this, it will take me to the Wikipedia page. So while making notes, if you want to add something extra, but you don't want your notes to become very big, then you can add hyperlinks. So when you're adding hyperlinks, the students will have access to those hyperlinks, and they'll also get extra information about that particular word, about that particular topic that you have introduced for the first time to them. Next option in insert is comment. Now for commenting, let's go to this page where we have added different things. So if I, let me take this page. So if this is the document that I have prepared, okay, and I want to comment, so I can say check the font size. So if I want them to check it, so I'll add a comment. ठीक है, सो whoever has this document shared with them will get this comment in their Gmail that there is a comment and that person is asking you to check the font or check the spelling. So wherever you get a plus sign like this plus sign basically indicates add comment. So if you see here on this toolbar, you're getting the plus sign. ठीक है, दैट इज वन ऑप्शन. राइट क्लिक करके भी कमेंट ऑप्शन आता है, दैट इज अनदर वे. नाउ इफ आई वांट टू सेंड अ कमेंट टू अ स्पेसिफिक पर्सन, नाउ फॉर एग्जांपल आई एम सेंडिंग इट टू माय अनदर अकाउंट, सो एट द रेट आई विल राइट द नेम ऑफ द पर्सन. ठीक है, सो आई एम असाइनिंग दिस कमेंट टू दिस पर्सन एंड आई एम सेइंग चेक द फॉन्ट साइज, सो ओनली दैट पर्टिकुलर पर्सन विल गेट नोटिफाइड. So when that person is getting notified, that person can come to this doc and can change it. So once that particular comment has been resolved, you click on this right side and you can say mark as resolved. If I have added a comment, but now I feel नहीं नहीं ऐसे नहीं होना चाहिए था, there must be something else added. I can edit it and I can add something to the this comment. If I want, I can delete the comment if I feel इसकी जरूरत नहीं है. If I want to provide a link to this, if I want to provide a link to the person, that person has not accessed Google Docs since long, I can copy this link and send it to that person through WhatsApp. So this commenting feature basically helps when you are working on a single doc. So if there are all grade 4 teachers who have come together and they are preparing notes for science or they are preparing a paper for examination, and you all are not getting time to meet at one specific time slot, so what you can do is share the document with each other, give editing rights. In the last session we saw that whenever we are sharing anything, we can give them the option to view, we can give them the option to comment, we can give them the option to edit. If you don't want them to edit it on their own, give them the option to comment. So what that person can do is they'll comment, please change this question, or you can add this question, please check the answer. So all the people who are on that document, who have access to that document, are basically getting a notification. So when you're getting the notification, you all can see what is convenient. If I've added a comment and then there is third person who feels, are this is correct, this change has to be done, that person can respond there that even I feel this change needs to be done. So it will save in a lot of time if these comments are added already on the notes or on the papers. When you're actually meeting to discuss the paper or to finalize the paper or to finalize the notes, you will be able to finish it in within a shorter period of time. So that is one of the advantage of commenting. Next we go to format. So when we go to format tool, first option is text. So I can either make the text bold. So if I'm selecting this, I go to format, I go to text, I make it bold. If I want, I can make this text italics. I go to format, I go to text, I can underline it. Then I go to text, I can superscript or subscript it. जब हम लोग reactions लिखते हैं, I can change the size, I can increase the font size or reduce the font size. Capitalization, I can make all of it uppercase. I don't want uppercase, so I'll select it again. I'll go to format, I'll go to text, I'll make it lowercase. If I don't want all of it lowercase, then I can again go to format, I select the text, I go to capitalization, and I use title case. Sentence case option is not there here. We have only title case, uppercase, and lowercase. Next is paragraph mein, what are the different options? So I can add the whole paragraph by using a border and shading. So if I'm selecting a border like this position, okay, I'm selecting a background color light yellow. I'm going to apply it. So I've got a border. So this is the border I have created to my document. Then next is adding a title, subtitle, heading. If you see here, you get a document outline. So if it's a document which is of 15 pages and you want to know what exactly is the summary, what are the topics that I included here, you go to document outline. So if you see first one, Google Doc, this is the heading. So I can select Google Doc. I go to format, I go to paragraph style, I make this as the title. Okay, so this becomes my title. Next, I want to go to step one. I'm telling how to create a Google Doc. So again, I go to format, I go to paragraph styles, I give this as heading one. So apply heading one. So this heading one is coming here. Then I can do it the same way for heading two, heading three, and so on. So let's take last one. We are taking this. We go to format, paragraph style, heading 4. Okay. Now if I go here, I'm on the first page. Okay. I click here. It will take me directly to this page, this heading. So that makes your work easier when you have the outline summary, and when you're adding headings, you can add headings from here also. So you have the option of normal text, title, subtitle, heading 1, 2, 3, 4. Next in format is align. Whether you want all of your information on left hand side, whether you want it in the center, whether you want it on the right side, or whether you want it justified. These four options are available here also. So if I'm selecting a paragraph, let's take this paragraph. So I can select this. Right now it's on the left hand side. I can bring it to center. I can bring it all to right side. Or I can use the last option here, which is justify. So if you see, all of this come in a straight line. If it is not justified, each sentence ends at a different level. If I justify it, all of it comes together in one line. So when you're preparing notes which have huge paragraphs, it is always advisable to justify it because it looks more neat and cleaner. Uske baad, how much spacing do I want in each paragraph? So if I've selected this, I go to format, line and paragraph spacing, I go to 1.5. The space between each one has increased. If I want to double it, I'll double the space. If I want to custom space, so if I want it as 0.5, I'll make it 0.5. So it comes jumbled in one another. So depending upon how much space you want in each of them, you can select that option. Next one is column. Now this whole document right now has only one column. If I select on these two columns, I'll get a document where I have things on both the sides. If I go again on format, I select three columns, I'll have my whole page divided into three columns. So you can use this option to check whether you want the whole document in one column, two columns, or three columns. Next one is numbering them. So if I want to number these, okay, I'll select this, I'll go to format. I go to format, I go to bullets and numberings, I go to numbered list, I go here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. If I don't want numbers 1, 2, 5, 6, I want only bullets. So I'll go to bullet, I'll go here. So all the bullets will come. So when you're making notes, instead of giving paragraphs, we generally prefer to write it in the form of points. So instead of numbering it as 1, 2, 3, 4, because they are not actually the steps, they are only the points related to a particular topic. So you can use the bullet option. Okay, so before I go ahead and explain the other things, I'm going to share a blank document with you. Okay, and I want you all to work on it. So I'm going to share it with you. Just let me copy the link. I have written few headings there and chota chota space choda. And now since there are a lot of people who are going to work on the same document, please make sure you all don't delete each other's work. So if you see some a line there, a red color line or a blue color line or a pink color line, that means somebody else is working in that space. Okay, so you all can do that. Or the other option is I can give each one a copy. So which one do you prefer?
Ma'am, I think giving each one a different copy.
Okay, theek hai.
Because so, otherwise you can get a confusion.
Ma'am, can you repeat the question?
I'm going to share a document with you all where I have given some headings. Okay. And whatever I have taught till now, I am going to ask you all to do that there. Okay, so I'm making copy for everyone. So click on the link, everyone will get their own copy. And then maybe 2-3 people can share their screen and show it to me what you all have done. So when you click on that link, it will give you an option, make a copy. Select on that, so everybody will have their own copy. Are you able to access it?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Chalo, we'll use maximum 2 to 3 minutes and then we'll start sharing what each one has done.
Ma'am, I missed out the link.
I've shared a link in chat. Yeah, you need to select that. Okay, you click on the link. It will ask you make a copy. Click on make a copy. You will get your own copy. And there are few questions. You have to do that.
Yes, got it, got it.
If you need any help, please ask me.
Hi ma'am, I missed the link. I'm not getting that link.
I'll paste it again. Are you able to do it?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Anyone who would like to share their screen and show what you have done?
Ma'am, just give me one other minute.
Okay, JK. teachers, if you need help, please let me know.
Ma'am, I'm not able to find shapes. So it is in
insert.
Insert, that's what I'm saying. Table, drawing, chart.
Drawing.
Yes. Okay, right now I've given you a copy. Okay, yeah, okay, ma'am, you can share your screen. So right now I've given you all the option of copy for each one. But if I have shared a normal link and everyone had started working on it and they have started destroying each other's work, what would you do then? What is the option to stop it?
Ma'am, editor.
You'll change the settings. Okay, yes. So right now when I'm sharing with everyone, I change the link settings to anyone with the link can view, can edit. So I'll go to the settings and quickly change it. Anyone with the link can view, so that yes, they ma'am. Can't edit, you know.
Yes, editor. Huh. So
you can share your screen, Lindsay ma'am.
I have to share entire screen. How to share, ma'am?
You can share a window also. Tab we use when you have to show a video or something. Okay. Window when you are showing one particular window, if you want to show different tabs, the whole screen, then you have to share the whole screen.
Nothing is happening.
No, it's correct. You go on the tab which you want to show. Yeah, click on that copy of assignment.
Where is it?
On top besides meet. There are tabs, no, besides meet. Third tab.
No, I'm not able to find out, ma'am.
You know the tab where you are right now, no? Google Meet.
Yes, ma'am.
Besides that, there is copy of assignment.
Let others share and let me just okay. Figure it out.
Anybody else who would like to
Madhvi,
share?
Madhvi ma'am, raise the hand, ma'am.
Yes, Madhvi ma'am.
Ma'am, I was just asking that I'm not able to make the copy okay. of it. It is just showing me that you can view only.
I'm not able to hear you, Madhvi ma'am. If you can be a little louder.
I'm saying that it is giving me an option of only viewing.
Only viewing.
Yeah. I'm not able to do anything on this page.
Okay. Check now.
Just a minute.
Okay. Shweta ma'am. It's done. Shweta ma'am has also shared.
So now it's done, ma'am.
Shweta ma'am has shared the screen. So she has added the table, she has added shapes, justify is done, correct. Tom and Jerry ka image dala hai, and page number, correct. Very good, Shweta ma'am. Yes, Shweta ma'am, you can stop sharing. Lindsay ma'am can share now.
Okay. I think you can you click to resume. Where is resume? I don't know what's happening. Just sit.
Lindsay ma'am, go to present now and choose to tab. In yeah. that, use a tab. All the tabs will come and choose the tab whichever you want to present.
Hmm. So now you can see.
Yeah, correct. Yeah, we can see.
So
you have added the table, correct.
Some shapes I was not able to add.
Okay.
Justification
is done. Tom and Jerry image you have added. And page number you have added on the top. Instead of lower side. Yeah, that is fine. Generally, page numbers lower
are
side.
On the hand.
So when you check, when you're adding the page number, just check whether it is showing the upper side or the lower side.
Sure, ma'am.
Okay,
sure.
Great. Thank you. So, ma'am, anybody has any doubt with what we have done till now?
Ma'am, just tell me once again to add the shapes because I didn't get it, ma'am.
I'll just do it.
Ma'am, do we have to fill form?
Is my screen visible? Sorry, Shweta, ma'am.
Ma'am, do we have to fill the Google Forms today also?
Yes, today also. It's every day, all 5 days.
Ma'am, can you share the link? Because my son has a class after this, so that I have to make him join the class.
I just finished this and I'll share it, okay? So, to add shape, you go to Insert, you go to Drawing, you go to New. Okay? Then there are different shapes here. So, you select whether you want to add a square, whether you want to add arrow, whether you want to add call out. So depending on that, you will select. Then you will go to save and close and it will get saved.
Sure. Okay.
So header, footer, page orientation. So gaya hai. Now we are left with only small things. So spelling and grammar. So if you have made any grammar mistake or if there are any spelling mistakes, you select this tool. Ask them to check the spelling and grammar. A document looks good. Agar mistake hota hai, toh it will keep on highlighting that document. It can tell you how many words are there. So right now there are 85 words, 2 pages, 447 characters, and characters excluding spaces is 367. So this can be used when you have to write a essay. So 100 words ka likho ya 200 words ka likho, that you can do. Citations, we are not going to go into detail right now. Translate document. So if I've made this document and I want to translate it in Hindi, so I can go to language, I'll go to Hindi, I'll go to translate. So this translated document will come here. Okay, so this also can be done when you're working on a Google Doc. And the next option is voice typing. Okay, this is going to be a savior for everyone. But when you're doing voice typing, please make sure you're using earphones. Taki awaaz clear ho jaye. So if I went to tools, I selected voice typing, this option came. So I'll click on this and then I'll say, hello everyone. I hope you all are fine. So as I'm speaking, it will keep on typing. So if your typing speed is not good or if you're too lazy to type on a particular day, you can use this option. There'll be slight errors. Those errors, it's easy to modify. So you will just have to add a full stop or small errors. Jahan pe you have to make the words capital or small, that you can do. So after you have finished speaking, you will stop it. So whatever you have spoken till now has come here. So this is one of the very easy way where you can get all your things typed. Bahut zyada matter type karna hoga. So that time you can use that option. Now, when you go to file, you can make a copy of this. So when I'm making a copy, same thing will be repeated again. So I made a copy. Now I can start working on this. I can rename this. I can download it as a Microsoft Word file. I can download it as a PDF. Version history. Okay. So version history, when I click on this, it tells me at what time which person has done any changes in the document. So if I'm clicking on this, I added this at 4:55. If I click on this, these are the changes that I did on August 24th. If I click on this, it was a blank document when I started with. So whoever has done the change, their name will come here. On which day they have done the change, at what time they have done, that will come. And when you click on the change, it tells you which particular change has been done. So if somebody has accidentally deleted something from your Word doc and you want to restore it now, so the best option with you is you go to version history. So if I want the this particular document now, I'll go to restore this version. If I don't want it, I'll go to back. I'll just come to know who are the people who have edited it. I can rename this document. I can move this document like I had showed last time. So if you remember we had made a star document called as training. So I'll go to training, I'll go to this folder, I'll move this document there. So then I have all of it saved in one particular place. So I guess I have covered all the things that are there in Google Doc. There is one more thing, add-on, which we'll not go into details right now. Add-ons basically are the things that we need extra to be added. So for example, if you want a feature jahan pe zyada emojis aate hain, yeah, or if you want some feature from Chrome extension which will help you to modify your Google Doc, you can add those. But we need to keep in mind, whenever we are adding any add-on, it's a third party operation. Okay, so Google is not responsible for its efficient working. So whenever you are adding any Chrome extension, we need to ensure that we check the ratings, we check what are the reviews, we check who is the person who has installed, who has made that particular software or who has made that particular add-on, and only then if we trust it, we can install it. I've put the link for Google Form for today's session in chat. You all can fill it. Till then, if you need any help, I want everyone to open a Google Doc, okay, and go through all the options that we have discussed today. So we basically discussed about insert, format and tools. Try all of it yourself, and if you have any doubt, you can ask me right now. And please also fill in the Google form for today. It's a feedback form. So you can use Google Docs for making notes, for sharing syllabus with students, for making papers where you're collaborating with your co-teachers, for writing the minutes of the meetings, for making a lesson plan. So these are the different ways where the teachers can use. For students to use, you can ask them to make posters or flyers or brochures, or making a story with emojis, or writing letters, writing a resume. So all these activities can be done. So when a student is sharing their document with you, you can keep on adding comments. So when you're adding comments, the student can modify that particular document according to your comments. So you don't have to write a separate mail ki these are the changes that are required. So you just add a comment, and that comment will reach the child, and the child can either reply to your comment or will follow what comment you have added. Yes, Saheli ma'am.
Ma'am, I am not able to go to the Google form. Can you please share once again?
Yeah, I'll just do it. So on day 5, we'll have a small activity where whatever things we have done till now, we'll test all of it. Okay? So sure. Keep practicing, and let's see how much you are able to remember.
Okay. And ma'am, for workshop name, what should I write?
L2? Module 2. Module,
module 2.
Yeah.
I've submitted, ma'am.
Okay. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, Lindsay, ma'am. Others, please submit the feedback form.